Just showing how ridiculous and dangerous this bill actually is. Welcome to another installment of the Connecticut Gun Bench. Today's video is brought to you by P.A.N. Firearms, LLC. P.A.N. Firearms for your NRA certification and multifaceted gun training. You can reach us at 203-300-6343 or use our website at www.panfirearmsllc.com. As always, there'll be a link in the description box below. And let's talk about this. As we know, in the judiciary right now, the House Judiciary Committee, HR 1808 is being debated to be moved forward for a vote. And as I did in the previous video, Sheila Jackson Lee and just ridiculous rhetoric. They talk about this thing about it's going to reduce gun violence and so-called mass shootings. And yet everything they propose does nothing of the sort. But there's been, obviously, there's going to be clapback from those with a little bit more sense and knowledge. And I'm going to play this video here. And I'm going to play them pretty much back to back. You're going to hear from Representative Massie, who's from Kentucky, and Representative Steube, who's from Florida. If you remember, Representative Steube had the guns at his house. He was doing a Zoom committee meeting, and he had his guns out trying to explain something. And Sheila Jackson Lee said, "I hope those guns aren't loaded." And he literally said, "Hey, this is my house. I do what I want with my guns." That guy. So let's go ahead and watch those.
Gentleman from Kentucky, seek recognition.
I move to strike the last word.
Gentleman's recognized.
This bill is unserious and unconstitutional. But we'll get into the unconstitutionality of it later during the debate as we offer amendments. But let me talk about the unseriousness of it. And some of what I'm about to show you may come as a surprise to the other side of the aisle. And you may want to go back and redraft it again, I don't know. But the 1994 to 2004 so-called assault weapons ban banned firearms by cosmetics and by name, much the same as this bill does, cosmetics and by name, without regard for the actual lethality of the firearm. And what happened between 94 and 2004 is the manufacturers, within a year or two, just changed the names and the designs of the firearms so that by 1996, they were making them all again. And then by 2004, there were at least twice as many of these types of firearms in circulation as there were before the ban. So I don't know how you make the argument that the 94 to 2004 ban reduced crime because it reduced the number of assault weapons, so-called, because it didn't reduce
the
number.
Gentlemen, yield for a second.
Just for a second. I will here in a little bit. I've got some other points I need to make. So the other side of the aisle says, this bill will ban weapons of war. Really? Will it? Let's look at the exempted list. You guys might want to get out the bill and check this. It exempts the M1 Garand. I'm going to read you. So you can still, after this bill passes, you can own an actual weapon of war. What they're calling weapons of war are not weapons of war. They're sporting rifles, but what they're not banning are the actual weapons of war. The M1 Garand is not banned by this bill. And in a letter to General Campbell from General Patton says, in my opinion, the M1 rifle is the greatest battle implement ever devised. Guess what? Not banned in this bill. The actual weapon of war. What else is it banned in this bill? The quintessential Chinese Army weapon of war. The SKS is not banned by your bill. Very charitable to allow people to own this piece of Cold War history. Here's the Chinese Army practicing drills with one of the weapons they're most proud of, which is the SKS. Not banned in this bill. An actual weapon of war. The bill does ban sporting firearms, though. What do we have here? Well, the gun they're primarily going after in this bill is the AR type firearm, which stands for Armalite, not assault rifle. It shoots this cartridge, 223. It was designed so that it was lighter weight. And it, frankly, it's not even suitable. I mean, some people use it to deer hunt, but it's not the preferred caliber for deer hunting. This is the cartridge that is used by the M1 Garand, which is not banned by this bill. It's many times, more powerful. Let's talk about another weapon of war. What do we have here? This is Iwo Jima. This is the M1 carbine, also not banned by this bill. A technical, literal weapon of war. Yes, they're over there whispering to themselves, oh my gosh, why didn't we ban that? Why didn't we think to ban that? Because you're not banning weapons of war. You're banning the most commonly sold sporting rifle in the United States right now. You're not banning weapons of war. If you were serious about it, you would ban the quintessential Chinese weapon of war. You would ban the rifle that General Patton, described as the finest battle implement ever devised. You would ban it, but you're not. And you would ban the M1 carbine that was used to take Iwo Jima, but you're not. You're not banning weapons of war. You're banning firearms that law-abiding people who are just exercising their Second Amendment rights go out and buy and purchase every day and use to defend their families.
With the gentleman's back, for what purposes, Mr. Steube, seek recognition.
Move to strike the last word, Mr. Chair.
Gentleman is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I would yield to a member on the Democratic side that served in a combat area designated zone and deployment of our country. Anybody in the Democratic side?
Mr. Steube, what's the purpose of the question? My father. No, let me finish. Let me finish.
Because I'm going to make a point, and you're taking my time. So I will yield to any member who
because
deployed.
I'm offended at your suggestion that somehow, if we've not served in a combat zone, that we don't care about protecting the lives of our constituents.
Has nothing
That's
to do
why
about
I'm
to me.
And for our family members who have lost
Mr.
blood,
time.
They should be respected.
Reclaiming my time. So, Mr. Chairman, I'd like 40 seconds back.
I've seen my constituents die in battle.
It's Mr. Steube's time. Gentleman is recognized.
And I will ask for 40 additional seconds that I was taken. Okay, so I served in Operation Iraqi Freedom. I served in the Army, and there's a lot of talk in Washington about weapons of war. And my purpose of yielding to one of my colleagues who may have served was to ask them a specific question of what type of firearm were you issued when you were deployed? And the answer to that question is a true what would be defined as a weapon actually used in war has a selector switch on it for fully automatic, three-round burst, and semi-automatic. So when I deployed in 2006 in Operation Iraqi Freedom, we were issued M4s in the United States Army. Those M4s had a selector switch on them. Those selector switch allow you to have fully automatic, three-round burst, or semi-automatic. Those firearms are not allowed for purchase in the United States today. So this cascading of weapons of war, what I was issued, and again, I would ask any person that served in a deployed environment, you are issued weapons that allow for fully automatic and three-round bursts. That is not available for purchase in the United States, and that is not what the Democrats are attempting to ban today because that's already banned. What we're talking about is a semi-automatic rifle that only is used in a semi-automatic form. So behind me is a typical AR platform weapon, and you can't see it because it's on this side, not the other side, that has a selector switch on it. That selector switch is only for fire or not fire, safe or not safe, and that is for a semi-matic operation of the weapon, which means every time I depress the trigger, a round comes out of the firearm. All right, next slide, and just move it over. This is the most popular handgun in the United States that was purchased as a Glock 19. It functions in exactly the same way as this rifle. It's a semi-automatic, just like that's a semi-automatic. The rifle's not available for purchase, don't have a selector switch for three-round bursts or fully auto. This is a semi-automatic handgun. As quick as I depress the trigger of this Glock 19, a round comes out of the chamber. The functionality between that weapon and this weapon are exactly identical. There is no difference. So you're banning a class of weapons that you don't like the look of, not because of functionality, not because of how fast a round comes out of the weapon, just because you don't like the way that they look, because they function exactly the same. Now move this one over one. So now this is a Glock 19. Glock 19 comes with a 15-round magazine, which under this bill is legal, although it's interesting that a couple weeks ago you banned 10-round magazines and then you changed it to a 15-round magazine. It's interesting to understand the thought process there, but that is for another time. This is a 6-hour P320, which some of you probably saw in one of the hearings on the magazine bans. I showed my P320. This comes with a 20-round magazine. So under this bill, because it has a 15-round magazine ban, this gun would be banned because you wouldn't be able to use it. Again, it functions exactly the same as that gun. It functions exactly the same. As fast as you depress the trigger is as fast as a round comes out. So now the next one. So that gun would be banned. That would be okay because you can put a 15-round magazine in it. This is a lever action. Under this bill, lever actions apparently are okay, but semi-automatic AR platform rifles are not okay, so we're going to discriminate against the type of firearms that we're going to use, despite the fact that the functionality is the same. The only difference here is after you depress the trigger and a round comes out, you have to reload using the lever action, which saves you maybe half of a second. The next one, which is also legal, is a tubular. This is a tubular 22, which, again, And Mr. Massie did a good job of highlighting how ridiculous the calibers of the bullets are. The Democratic majority is discriminating against some of the most popular weapons in the United States simply because they don't like the way they look, not because of the way they function. And there are so many Americans that are confused when they see the semi-automatic rifle that the Democrats want to ban as being fully automatic. It's not. You can't purchase that. It's illegal. It is not a weapon of war. A weapon of war has a fully automatic switch or a 3-round burst. I yield back the remainder of my time.
Okay, you heard that and you saw that, and Massie laid it out. You're claiming to want to ban weapons of war, yet here are items that are actually classified as weapons of war. You saw the little note there from Patton about the M1 Garand, yet these aren't banned. These aren't banned, but these items, because of the way they look, are banned. And then Steube opened the door to something that I've been talking about quite a bit. This bill opens the doorway to an even greater expansion of the ban, because as he pointed out, an AR-15 works exactly the same way as a Glock 19. One pull of the trigger fires one shot. So if you're talking about banning these based on that theory, then these could easily be thrown right underneath the bus. And I believe that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to ban all semi-automatics of any kind, eventually. That's eventually what they're after. And of course, that's gonna lead to a complete ban across the board. It could very easily be led that way, because none of these things are going to stop people from committing murder or so-called mass shootings. As I pointed out before, because they're using their definition of what a mass shooting is, because the FBI definition is different, just based on the number of people. They lowered the number of people and the severity. That's why they come up with this 352 mass murder numbers. It's a bunch of garbage. They're throwing in drug deals gone bad and gang violence. You know, notice they're not talking about, especially the Democrats, are not talking about gang violence at all, which is where most of this stuff is coming from. Because the liberal cities, the Portland, Detroit, so forth, Chicago, have let the criminals run the city. That's where the majority of these so-called mass shootings are coming from. But they lump them all together to get you to think like, oh my God, there was a mass shooting, and have you mentally associate it with Parkland or Uvalde or some other event that was very public. And it's not. But I congratulate the Steube Massie for stepping up and doing and putting it out there. You people don't know, you have no idea what you're talking about. And you're doing this off the cuff, and it's not going to prevent what you claim it will, but they already know it's not going to. That's the whole point. It's not about people's lives. It's about control over the masses. And it's unfortunate. You know, I always say to make, you put the saying out there, some people have to feel the whip on their back before they finally admit they're a slave. But let me know what you think. As always, you can leave your comments in the comments section below. And as always, any statements of violence or statements that lead to violence will be removed. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you get notified the next time a video goes live. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.